In this video, I will show you how to connect multiple Repeater Server Pro installations with each other and external programs with Repeater Server. Connecting multiple Repeater Server Pro installations offers you several advantages. Raspberry Pis and other cheap computers are very popular and are completely sufficient, but the computing power is not outstanding when rendering preview images and videos, especially if you want high quality. If you connect a Repeater Server Pro installation on a slow computer with a fast computer, computationally intensive tasks can be transferred to the fast computer. This allows you to work with the slow machine almost as fast as a fast one. This makes it easy to connect multiple 3D printers to a Raspberry Pi, print, upload files, and create time-lapse videos at the same time without overloading the computer. To add an alternative server, go to Connectivity in the Global Settings. Click Add and enter the server name, API key, IP address, and the port of the other server. You find the IP address and port on the dashboard and the API key in Connectivity in the Global Settings. The port is normally 3344. Then select if you want to use it for time-intense computations. This only makes sense if the other computer is faster. You can also select that you want to have access to the stored projects. Here's a comparison when rendering the preview image for a G-code. After uploading the G-code to the server, rendering starts as soon as the G-code is analyzed and the spinner disappears. My Raspberry Pi 3B Plus renders the image in 44 seconds. Then I outsource this computation and Connectivity in Global Settings to my remote server. The faster the remote computer is, the more time you save. When I send the task to my fast computer, I get the image in 12 seconds. The larger the file, the more noticeable this becomes. If you allow access to stored projects, you can change the server at the projects and get access to all data, including the G-code stored there. You could use the G-codes there to print them on another server. You can also connect Repeater Server to other programs. For example, Repeater Server Monitor allows you to connect any number of servers into one desktop app and manage all printers from your control center, perfect for printer farms and users with many printers. You can connect to the Repeater host. Then you can store G-codes directly on the server and control the server from the host. But also other slicers like Prusa Slicer, Simplify 3D and Cura can be connected to Repeater Server to store the sliced G-code directly on the server. In the description I post the links how to connect Repeater Server Monitor, Repeater Host, Prusa Slicer, Simplify 3D and Cura with Repeater Server. And because your data belongs only to you, the programs all connect directly to each other, there is no data transfer via the internet. Therefore, they work even without an internet connection in your intranet. If you wish, you can have the printer notify you via push message to your smartphone when certain events occur, for example when a print is finished or has been cancelled or paused at a predefined point. To do this, you can use Repeater Informer and Pushover or other providers like CallMeBot, which sends you free messages via WhatsApp, Telegram, Signal or Facebook Messenger. For this function, an internet connection is of course required. And Repeater Server supports smart home systems such as Home Assistant, IO Broker, IFTTT, and the IoT Messaging Standard MQTT, which gives you countless opportunities. We wish you a lot of fun with Repeater Server Pro, the software for all printing professionals and those who want to become one.